This is the SAP Developer News for April 10th, 2025.
We are delighted to inform you that two cool technologies, the Knowledge Graph Engine and the Generative AI Toolkit, have been launched in SAP HANA Cloud. The Knowledge Graph Engine enables you to model and analyze complex relationships within data stored in SAP HANA Cloud. Native RDF triple store support enables semantic data storage and querying using the resource description framework. It also enhances LLM responses by grounding them in business-specific knowledge stored within the knowledge graph, providing more accurate and contextually relevant outputs. A lot of smart words, I know, so you better try it yourself. I plan to make the new SAP CodeGem exercises available shortly. Let me know in the comments if you are interested. The Generative AI Toolkit simplifies the development of intelligent data applications by providing a natural language interface for creating in-database machine learning models, reducing the need for extensive coding from your side. Although, following recent updates in the LangChain review process, our engineering team has published a new LangChain integration for SAP HANA Cloud package. You can now easily leverage features like in-database embeddings, full-text search, and vector indexes directly within LangChain. Interested in discussing this and other aspects of SAP HANA? The very first HANA TechCon will take place at SAP headquarters in Germany on July 10th. Please check the published agenda and register if you are interested. I'm looking forward to meeting you there.
Hello, everyone. I have got some interesting news for the open source enthusiasts. There is an upcoming SAP open source webinar on the topic Apeiro Reference Architecture, Strengthening Digital Sovereignty for Europe. It is on May 8th at 3 p.m. CEST. The Apeiro Reference Architecture is a part of initiative and aim to build a high-performance cloud edge infrastructure with open source standards. Peter Giese, head of SAP Open Source Program Office, will give you an overview on why and how this project has been transferred into the new NeoNephos Foundation, which will serve as a neutral entity dedicated to fostering open collaboration and governance. There is also a LinkedIn post by Michael Amling explaining the NeoNephos Foundation, where several flagship open source projects such as Gardena, Garden Linux, and more are transferred to NeoNephos through this initiative. Vasu Chandrasekhara, Chief Product Owner of Apeiro, will explain the landscape of Apeiro reference architecture with an overview of the architecture and the components. Please find the registration links to the webinar in the description below.
A March 2025 release of the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model is out. The new version 8.9 brings important changes to you. But before we dive in, I just wanted to remind you that there is a new CDS parser version coming out with the next major version 9.0. So make sure to comply to all the new changes and that your projects keep on running. You can use the new parser now by setting the new parser flag to true to try them out in your project today. So you might as well go ahead and do it. A new change with 8.9 brings you actions to generated child entities when defining a composition of aspect. This is really nice, bringing you action capabilities when reflecting document structures in your domain models. Recursive hierarchies and Fiori tree table support is out now, available in beta, allowing you to serve read requests for the SAP Fiori tree table control. Version 8.9 is introducing a new CDS command, which is CDS up. CDS up will build and deploy your CAP applications to Cloud Foundry. And if you need to deploy to Kuma, simply add the argument --2 Kubernetes to the end of the command. And the last thing I want to mention is that you can now use the CDS deploy to HANA command for deploying to Kubernetes as well. So just add the argument of --on Kubernetes at the end of the command for the magic to begin. And there are more changes in the current release, which we aren't covering here. So make sure to read the official release notes on the CAP documentation page. And as always, the link is in the description below.
Hi everyone, I've got some exciting news to share, especially if you're a student just like me, working with SAP or just curious to know what SAP is all about, the Learning Hub Student Edition is live. And the best part of it is free for all actively enrolled students. And here's what you can get. Full access to content available to customers, to certifications attempts, access to live expert sessions, hands-on cloud-based training systems, plus content to help you get certified over time. If you're wondering, what is SAP? Don't worry, I got you covered. There is a blog post link below. Definitely give that a read if you are new to SAP world. And how do you get started? Let me break it down real quick. Create your SAP Universal ID. This is like your learning passport, so make sure you use your email address of your university to do so. Verify that you are a student using the email address attached or tied with your enrollment. And while waiting for the activation link to get to your inbox, you can already start checking out the student Zoom and exploring courses and even start learning. You can also activate your subscription by checking your inbox to activate the link. If you don't see it on your inbox, check the spam folder just in case. And you can also start learning and pick up from where you left or choose new topics from your student Zoom account. Also, you can also start practicing on the cloud-based training systems. This is really, really important because here you switch or you turn your theories into real skills. And also, you can also join live sessions and ask expert questions and also learn what is happening in the field. When you think you're done or when you think you've got learned enough, you can already book from the Learning Hub certification exams. Remember, you got a free attempt. Before I go, just few quick FAQs. All student email address won't get you access, so make sure you are actively enrolled. And the subscription lasts for 12 months, but if you're still enrolled, you can renew it. And remember, the certification exam is only for 2 attempts, if only you pass on the first draw. So, if you're still unsure where to start, I got you covered. You can check out the Discovery SAP for Students or Positioning SAP Business Suites. And remember, if you ever get stuck, the SAP community is always there for you. For more information, please check out the blog post. Happy learning and good luck on your SAP journey. Ciao.
Because of all the travels, I'm misinforming you that SAP BusinessObjects BI 2025 is now available. But thanks, Josh, for reminding me. SAP BusinessObjects BI 2025 brings a fresh set of enhancements that make your business analytics more efficient, user-friendly, and future-proof. BI 2025 offers powerful enhancements designed to help you help your business users make faster and more informed decisions. This release isn't just about the new features. It's about ensuring that your BI platform remains secure, flexible, and ready for the future. Please check the Welcome to SAP BusinessObjects BI 2025 blog post and share your thoughts in the comments there. And by the way, Greg, Eric, yes, I still have it.